he wants in his show. Brother called me up. First thing I said to him, and I said it like this, I don't have a budget.
Yeah.
He said, nobody say anything about a budget? Mm. I'm coming to share and minister what God is doing. And after all that, we're finally going to get to the brother's name.
Huh?
Joseph Joshua, y'all.
Shout out to the boy Joseph Joshua in the building, man.
Appreciate your love. Appreciate your love.
All right, sir. Get me off the mic. Take about 5 minutes and introduce yourself to everybody.
All right, all right. Joseph Joshua. I was originally born Cincinnati, Ohio. Eventually moved to Louisville, Kentucky, Clarksville, Tennessee. And went back to the 502, had some business to take care of out there. I'm an author, I'm a speaker, I'm a husband, father, mentor, motivational speaker. I have other things going on. I'm the founder of the Wisdom and Wealth Movement, and we have a list of other things that's going on as well. I don't want to say too many things because I don't want to sound like I'm puffing myself up, but I have a few different things going on as well, and I'm also a business owner.
So are you doing this all yourself?
Supporting. Coming down here myself? Absolutely.
And that was my point. There's a difference between... forget the difference. I just noticed right off the bat in speaking with this brother that he has a heart to serve. A servant's heart is what we call it. And it's going to be a great day tomorrow. It is going to be a great day. Number one, because we're all on the same page. Folks aren't coming here to get rich. Folks aren't coming here to make a bunch of money off of ticket sales. Folks are coming here to put on display the gifts and the talents that God has put in them to minister. And the whole show is a ministry because we're showing that you can be successful. You can be successful in music. You can be successful and you can do it and still have a relationship with God, with Jesus Christ. You could have that relationship first and watch all this stuff comes when you're doing what he put you here to do. His plan, his purpose, because he has a purpose for us all. Sir, you have 1, 2, 3 books. Are these, I will praise you, I will, oh, and your music. So this is what we're gonna do. Because we also have, that you heard in the very beginning, DJ Trayo, y'all, is in the house. We're going to briefly talk about the books, maybe just the title and why the titles. And DJ Trayo is going to entertain. He's going to mix for the next 10, 12 minutes or so. And then we'll come back and we'll talk about the books.
Absolutely.
So let's start with Wisdom, the World's Greatest Hidden Treasure.
Okay, the reason why that book has that title, because wisdom is indeed the world's greatest hidden treasure. When we go to Proverbs, in the book of wisdom, all right, it says, she is more precious than rubies, and out of all things you may desire, there's nothing to be compared unto her. It's another wisdom book called Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha. All right, it's part of the original King James Bible. And in Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7 and 14, it says, she is a treasure unto men that never faileth. When you go to Job chapter 28 verse 20, he said, where is the place of wisdom and where is the place of understanding, seeing that she is hidden from the eyes of all men and kept closed from the fowls of the air? Seeing that she is hidden. So Job calls it hidden. Solomon calls it a treasure. I call it the hidden treasure.
There it is. Book number 2. The spiritual and prophetic meaning of numbers.
All right, so this book right here has been on demand. So many individuals, they have dreams of numbers, dreams and visions about numbers. And what they do is they go straight to Google and YouTube and they type in these numbers and get angel numbers, right? Or go to some mystical, spooky things where our Heavenly Father has a language, a numeric language that he speaks throughout the scriptures. And I just happen to be one of the individuals walking the earth that he decided to share that language with. And I'm sharing it with the people.
We have the 12 fundamental laws of wisdom.
All right, so in my search of wisdom years ago, I came across 12 fundamental principles that kept showing their face over and over and over again, and I decided to put together that book, the 12 fundamental laws of wisdom, to give individuals a simple way of living a life according to wisdom.
All right, sir. And we got some of your music here. So what we're going to do is toss it over to Treo. He's going to do his thing, and we're going to come back, and we're going to jump into these three books, and we're going to talk a little bit about your music. This is Really Real Radio, the TGP show, y'all. DJ Treo, it's you.
Let's go. Top in the morning, I pray and I eat. Spread, I thank God for the feast. Please don't compare what you can, I compete. Favor all on me, I can't be free. I don't need time right now, but take my peace. Bible on deck and I'm quick to release. Yeah, I'm not surprised anymore if they're plotting on me. I counted the blessing, I get it, it's gonna be seen. Ooh. Leave it to God to get even. Changing my circle, I'm working, it's right for the season. I took a walk up the boat with my faith in the deep end. I'm a little hood and she loves a Christian. 1 million, nobody like me. Made this image, I copy the king. Know I'm a champion, give me a ring. Trophy game winner, we taking a scene. Keeping the parts, I'm strong, I see. Baby, don't worry, if you gotta see. Respect my name with a capital P. 16 years
old, I'm shaking my face. Coming to church, I'm shaking my dreads. I hear everything they said. I'm just trying to get these things out. I believe everything I read. Yeah. Old test, then new test. Speak with a devil like Ruth Chris. Old Chris, not new Chris. Old Jesus Christ, do this. They don't see us at the movies. Netflix, like a school beat. Battleship, man, cruising. Worship, the spirit moving. Fire and bones on tooling. I just told them out and move it. Fire and I can't cool it. We ain't cool.
Hey, Chris, chill. Let me pray for them boys real quick. Father, I will ask for forgiveness for all of our sins. The wrongs we did, knowing my money. Pray for my son, that's how I'm gonna get this kid down. Young man.
I was calling, I don't see no favor. Listen, drop a call. Me and Christian, be no trans, but you, Jesus, just calling on. You on the side, it's all you Christian church. You be not enough. On the side, I'm supposed to be your hood. And you an altar call from the brother.
Alright, y'all. That is DJ Treo. He will be back. But we are here today with Joshua. Joseph Joshua. You have two first names. So do I. Thomas Phillips. Well, Phillips is not a first name, but Philip is a first name. Alright, sir. Let's talk about your books real quick. The 12 Fundamental Laws of Wisdom. Let's talk about that. First of all, what is wisdom?
Wisdom, according to the scriptures, the definition of this, the ability to live skillfully. And we know that that skill gives us the advantage over the individuals that are not walking with that skill.
Got it. So the wisdom that we get from God's word, what does that help us do?
It helps us to live a more peaceful, prosperous, productive lives. It gives us length of days, long life, peace. It gives us innumerable riches, long-lasting friendships, and so much more.
And what was it that caused your search for wisdom?
Well, back in 2004, which is 20 years ago, I was just coming off the streets into the church. And, you know, I was introduced to wisdom at a new beginners class. And the lady that was teaching the class, she was just so passionate about this topic of wisdom. So I went on my journey back 20 years ago, and they was talking about reading the proverb every single day. So I was doing that every single day throughout the month. And of course, 20 years ago, I had 20 years less experience than what I have now. So it wasn't always, everything wasn't meshing the way it needed to mesh. But I continued to, you know, go over the proverbs, go over the scriptures. And then right around 2013, I was introduced to the Apocrypha. If you all don't know what the Apocrypha is, it's a little red book that was in the King James Bible, the 1611 version. The 1611 version had 80 books, and it was reduced to 66. 14 of those books were called the Apocrypha. Two out of those 14 books were two other book, wisdom books called Wisdom of Solomon and Ecclesiasticus. And once I got introduced to Ecclesiasticus, I call it Proverbs on steroids. And when I got a hold of that book, it changed the trajectory of my life moving forward.
You want to go into detail?
Absolutely. So when you go into Ecclesiasticus, I never read a book that when you got finished reading the Proverbs, it was like your brain was sizzling. That's the effect that the Ecclesiasticus had. And so it had to be some type of reason. I'm not going to get into all of it or why those two books didn't make it. But Wisdom of Solomon has a lot of fine wisdom inside of there. Ecclesiasticus is written by a man named Joshua ben Sirach. He was a ancient Israelite of the ancient times. He compiled all the wisdom of the ancients. And he's kind of doing similar to what I'm doing today. But he was compiling the older wisdom. And he put it out there for the people like you and I to feast on it.
The second book is The World's Greatest Hidden Treasures. And you have three books here. Well, one is on numbers. Is wisdom tied into this book as well?
Wisdom is tied to numbers. When you go to Psalms chapter 90 and verse 12, it said, teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. So wisdom and numbers, they do have a connection with each other. But that book is not mainly focused on wisdom. It's just focused on the spiritual and prophetic meaning of numbers.
Tell me about it.
Okay, so individuals, when they see numbers, going back to 20 years ago, coming in the church, basically what you would hear pastors speak on, they would talk about the number 3, the number 7, but they wouldn't really go into any depth about those numbers. They just kind of scratch the scratch. Whereas some of these definitions have been revealed to me throughout my studying and throughout me looking over my life. Now, when I looked over my life, I started to see patterns. Now, I don't want to sound spooky on the airways, but I started to see that even my Heavenly Father had dictated certain addresses and certain state routes and certain phone numbers around this number 12 and this number 9 and different numbers that I would see. And I'd be like, wow, what is this all about? And then as I began to pray and I continued to fast and I continued to seek, I just started to see that this is a hidden language. And so when I go to the scriptures, let me just give you an example, like the number 40. So if I was to ask anyone here in the studio audience, what does the number 40 mean? What would anyone say in here?
One more than 39.
One more than 39. Anyone else? Just a quick guess. All right, so the number 40, when we look at the number 40, this is how I draw definitions. I'm giving you a quick example. So when I look at the number 40 in the scriptures, the number 40 has to deal with judgment. All right, why would I say that it has to deal with judgment? When you look at Eli, the high priest that was ruling the temple, all right, his sons was in the temple. They say they was dealing with the women, prostitutes, different things of that nature. Well, our Heavenly Father did not kill Eli right away. He waited to the 40th year of his reign, and then he took his life. Solomon, he ruled for 40 years. The Most High took his life. David, he ruled for 40 years. The Most High took his life. It rained 40 days and 40 nights in the days of Noah, and that was a result of judgment. Y'all get where I'm going with this? So that's how I draw my definition. Aaron, Moses' brother, on the 40th year of them coming out of Egypt, he died as a result of judgment. But he'd been made the golden calf way before the 40th year. But our Heavenly Father waited to the 40th year to take his life. 40 means judgment. And that deals with the number 4. And it also deals with the number 400. You know, 400 years of slavery. The children of Israel had to be in bondage in another land that was not theirs. The number 4, when you go to the book of Ezekiel, it talks about the 4 sword judgments. So 4, 40, and 400, they all have to deal with judgment. So that's just one number, and it's a whole host of other ones. So when you go through the scriptures and you started to see these different numbers, and you start to see the meaning of them, like the number 7 and how it has to deal with rest and being blessed and set apart and all these different things, you'll start to see that, wow, hold up, this is really a language. Just like individuals will invest time learning the Greek language, the Hebrew language, the Latin, Spanish, these different dialects, well, numbers is a language all by itself.
Thanks. Wow. That's kind of deep. That really is. Which book did we not talk? I think we talked about all three. So it sounds like you've dedicated a serious amount of time to understanding not just wisdom, but the numbers as well.
Absolutely.
I think you said like 20 years.
Huh? It's been close to 20 years for both of them.
So if somebody reads your book, are you saving them 20 close to 20 years of trial and error?
Absolutely. It was saving them a lot of time. And, you know, so both of those books, all three of them, you know, it could take months to years to really compile and get together everything that I put together in those three books. It takes a lot of time, takes a lot of study, a lot of praying, a lot of, you know, having different notebooks, putting things together. And so for a very small nominal fee, you're able to reduce your study time into a fraction, and you can be able to gain the knowledge and the wisdom that our Heavenly Father has put before us. And it will give length of days, long life, peace, innumerable riches, happiness, and so much more.
Yeah. All right. Let's switch gears just a bit to the world's greatest hidden treasure, wisdom. I'm going to read what it says on the back. Wisdom, the world's greatest hidden treasure, is a guide for those who have a burning desire to understand and obtain wisdom. As you explore the treasures hidden within this book, you will discover many solutions to the inevitable problems of life. The wisdom commandments within this book come from the four wisdom books within the King James Bible, the Apocrypha. If you are searching for answers in the areas of moral wisdom, spiritual development, personal relationships, financial wisdom, business wisdom, communication skills, and much more, this book is for you. So a person can learn communication skills by reading the four books of the Bible?
Absolutely. That's wisdom? From the wisdom books. This is, for instance, when we go to Ecclesiastes 11:8, it said, "Answer not before you have heard the calls, neither interrupt men in the midst of their talk." How many of us every single day when an individual is talking, we cut them off because we act as if what they have to say is not as important as what we have to say. And what that really is pride. And pride is actually sin, not in the first five books, but in the laws of wisdom.
I sure hope Cassandra's not listening to the show.
So, you know, think about all of the hack, the flack that we cause with our mouth. You know, the scripture says honor and shame is in the talk, and the tongue of a man is his fall. And he talks about that in Proverbs. I mean, it talks about, you know, even a fool is counted wise when he holds his peace and esteemed a man of understanding. So that's one of the shortest.
Say that again.
Even a fool, the scripture says, he that hath knowledge spares his words, and a man of understanding is of an excellent spirit. Even a fool is counted wise when he holds his peace and esteemed a man of understanding.
Good stuff.
She's probably listening, so I'm just preparing for later on today.
Yeah. Yeah. Facts.
Me and my question.
You and your questions.
2025. All right, we really gonna change gears now. So you're a rapper, right? That lady right there that called, she's my fiance. We're about to get married. She actually has a radio show herself.
Okay.
And that, when I asked you that question, I had no idea. The Bible said don't cut people off.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Laws of wisdom. But guess what? There are so many individuals, there are millions of other individuals just like that, like you, that do not have a clue that it's in there neither. Individuals that actually claim to be wise, you have individuals that may be a little more seasoned, and they say, I got enough wisdom, but that's like they don't understand how valuable that is to just let someone finish their speech before you cut them off. Because what that does to a person that's called an introvert is they have to muster up all of this strength, and they got to muster up all these different, you know, they have overcome all this fear, and when they finally begin to start talking to an individual, someone else overtalks them, and it puts this big old wall up, and it makes them want to shut down and not say anything else.
You know, I first realized I was interrupting people and speaking really fast, and when I was in sales, I had a sales career, and the reason I trained myself to not interrupt people then was because money was on the line.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. I'm putting my foot in my mouth, it's, left and right.
It's just growing. You see it. You see it. It's just the wisdom.
Oh, you gonna jump right in? Wow, wow. But I'm thinking, if I can control my cutting people off when there's money involved, how much more should it be important that I don't cut people off when love is involved?
Absolutely.
When God's word is involved.
Uh huh.
It's what is important to you.
Absolutely.
That will cause that. Yeah.
Can I say one more thing before we move
Absolutely.
On?
Absolutely.
The proverb says, the fruit of the righteous is the tree of life, and he that wins souls is wise. Mm-hmm. So we have to be able to listen to individuals. We have to let them be able to share, because some of these individuals down here in Atlanta, and I rode through here, I know we in the hood, yeah. Right? So when you go into these individuals and you talking to them and you getting to know individuals better, you have to let them speak without cutting them off. And then what they're going to do is they're going to give you the admonition so that when it's your turn to speak, you can intelligently interject what you need to share with them. But if we keep cutting them off, we don't get too far in the conversation. And then that person, when we finally leave, they like, man, who is dude right there, man? Get dude out of here. But if I listen to this person and I let them pour out their heart and they share what is, what's going on in their mind, what really is bothering and hurting them, and then I can be able to share with them in a more effective way, then I done won a brother.
So, how long have you been doing music?
I started music in 1994 on the washer and dryer in my house. Brother of mine named Barry, you know, he came over. I was 10, 11 years old, and we were just he cassette tapes. You know, we would rap over other people's beats, and you know, that's when the music thing started for me back in 1994. I did it in the streets, and then around 2006. I got onto the Christian rap thing, and I was doing that for a while. And then around 2012, I still, of course, do music for the Most High, but I started to kind of interject put his name into my music. And so a lot of times in churches, we say, you know, praise his name, call on his name, but we really don't say what his name is. And so I start putting his name in my music and different things of that nature. So 1994, to go back to it.
Do you have in your music what you write about in your books?
Well, I'm actually about to start working on the Wisdom album now. I'm two songs into this new album. That CD that I gave you, that was back in 2016-17. So once I stopped doing music, I started to write books. So I haven't put out a fresh album in some years, but I'm coming back on the scene, and I'm going to be putting out Wisdom music this time.
Okay. Well, if you need some place to create, we got a recording studio.
Absolutely.
I'm just saying. All right, DJ Trey O.